Well, my name is Baba Aundar. Of course, my family and friends call me Baba Aundar, those who know me. I'm a student of history, and I believe it's important that we tell our story. So, coming out of an African-centered educational institution where I served as an instructor for a number of years, I learned a great deal about us as a people, which I share with the young people in the classroom on a daily basis. About a few years ago, I put together the presentation, A Message to the People, A Story of Malcolm X, because I believe it is important that we tell the story, the life story of Malcolm X, because the past is the foundation for the present and the future. Well, Malcolm X is one of my heroes, and I think he has had a significant impact on the history of America and the world. And to kind of give you a little background, about 1982, I read the autobiography of Malcolm X. And then in 1988, I reread the autobiography of Malcolm X. And based on reading the life story of Malcolm X, I found some very important information that helped to transform my own life. So around 1992, I went into education as an instructor at a private school. And every year we celebrated the life of Malcolm X on May 19th. It was a tradition, it was part of our cultural practice. So throughout those years, for basically almost 20 years, I was engaged in raising up the name of Malcolm X, remembering his great contribution to humanity. So when I was no longer teaching at the school, then I went into, of course, producing, in the sense of producing ways in which we could tell our story. And I looked at the life of Malcolm X and I saw some significant things that needed to be raised up so we can have a better understanding of what has happened, what is happening, and what we need to do to give a greater direction to us as a people. So basically to say that in the whole foundation of A Message to the People, A Story of Malcolm X, I realized that through his life story, it empowers us as a people. If we hear his story, understand his story, and understand that his story is our story. So, of course, Malcolm X being a person who is an iconic figure in America and the world, I think people can relate to his story. But what I'm also discovering and finding is that a lot of people don't know his story. As I mentioned, when I first read the autobiography of Malcolm X and reread it, that's the point that I started to understand the significance of Malcolm X in my own life. See, Malcolm to me demonstrated the power of transformation, the power of change. And it was some key components in that book, in the life of Malcolm X, that helped me to understand that I could change my own life if I wanted to do something different, to be better, and to have a greater impact on my community, my family, and the world. So one thing that brought to life for me in the life of Malcolm X is that you have the power to change, but you need knowledge. You need to have a better understanding of yourself as an African, as a member of the human family, and as some of our great scholars would say, we are agents where we have an impact, we make history, and we can change the world. So Malcolm X's life brought that to me. And then, of course, I have to say that by reading and studying the life of Malcolm X, I started to change my diet. I started to change how I dress. I started to change how I talk. And what I saw is that, you know, it was a struggle, but it was a struggle I was committed to. And struggling to change myself, I then started having effects on other people. And I think this was testimony to the fact that this is really the significance of Malcolm, is that Malcolm not only changed himself, but he started changing, as we say, changing the world. Yeah, for the people that have come out to the presentation and have seen the performance, they have expressed a great appreciation to the fact that We are keeping Malcolm alive in history. They have shared with me how certain aspects of the presentation impacts them. Because I recall it was a young lady who was telling me how, because in the presentation we were talking about education and the importance of building educational institutions and taking control of the education of our children. And she shared with me how just through the presentation, and when I was talking about this in the presentation of Malcolm X, she made a point that she was going to take charge of the education of her children because she realized that they were not going to get this kind of information, this kind of knowledge in the present situation they're in the public school system.
And Africans are the builders of great nations like Egypt, Ghana, Mali, and Shanghai. See, we gotta teach all children the truth. And if they won't teach it in their schools, then you gotta open up your own schools and teach your own children. And if they won't write it in their books, then you gotta write your own books and tell your own story.
So I saw her a couple of weeks later, and she was saying that she had already started engaging in the process of making sure she had books in the house and making sure that she shared this information with her children. So other people have shared with me from seeing the presentation is that they've been empowered. They have been realigned with what Malcolm and the significance of Malcolm was in history. And it, in some, I think has inspired them to say, look here, Malcolm did this in the past and I can do this in the present. I mean, so many things Malcolm said in the past, and the great part of the past is that in Malcolm's lifetime is that we have recordings. There were people writing books, have written books about Malcolm. There are audio recordings of speeches that Malcolm gave, so we can hear the things that Malcolm said, and then we can take that and to the present and listen to what kind of conversations are we having? What kind of things are we talking about today? And we can see that what Malcolm talked about are the same issues that we need to address today. So what Malcolm did, he was giving good instructions then. And for some, we have followed those instructions. But I think less effect, we have not followed those instructions. So now what I'm discovering is that through this presentation, A Message to the People, A Story of Malcolm X, we're able to connect the past of what Malcolm said and the present of what's going on so we can hear these issues. For instance, in the presentation, we raise up the importance of education and Malcolm talking about the need for us to educate our children. So that's the issue that's being raised up today. Now you see more African-centered schools. You see more people taking charge of their education of their children with homeschooling and through sometimes charter schools. So you see people being having a greater commitment to making sure that children learn about our history and our story. And then another part of the presentation, we talk about the imprisonment of Black men, Black people. And of course, Malcolm talking about, basically he said that if you're Black in America, you're in prison. But the fact is, he was really bringing forth what is presently going on today, because now we see a high incarceration rate of Black men in prison.
So don't be surprised when I say I was in prison. You still in prison. Right now today, Black people are 12% of the US population, but you almost 50% of the prison population. And who's flying the drugs into this country? You don't have no airplanes. They won't hardly let you near the airport.
Including Black women now. And then we see some of the same basic elements being played out. And Malcolm was telling us then, no, we need to straighten up. We need to clean up and stand up and be people of moral fortitude. So, you know, I'm just saying that Malcolm, what he said in the past is very relevant today. And I think through this presentation, people are starting to connect the fact that, hey, this is something that was said in the past, but we need to talk about it and we need to follow the instructions that have been given and then add on to those instructions that other people have laid the foundation for to help give us a clear path to self-empowerment, self-improvement, self-determination. Every time I do this presentation and share this information about Malcolm, I learn more about Malcolm X because I go listen to his tapes, I watch some of his interviews, I read about him, I study him, and I see that there's a lot more that I'm learning about our great brother. But what I'm also seeing that is a challenging part, because as I'm talking to people and sharing this information in the spirit of Brother Malcolm, I understand that this is something I have to embrace also. And I'm saying embrace it in the sense of I have to also continue to change my life, to transform, to become the best man, best human being, the best African I can be. I gotta be committed to changing and transforming my life so I can change and transform my family, my community, and in the world I want to live. So when people are there and they are engaged in this presentation with me, I want them to walk away understanding that they have the power to change. They have the power to transform. They have the power to create the world they want to live in, we want to live in. But to have and understand that power, we got to have certain things that we incorporate within our lives. See, Malcolm was a studious man. He read, he got the knowledge, and he encouraged us to do likewise. So I want us to walk away understanding that we're gonna have to read, we're gonna have to get the knowledge and understanding of us as a people in our role in world history. And then we're gonna have to understand through the life of Malcolm is that now incorporate that knowledge and make it real. We can't just have it in our head, but we gotta put it in our heart, and then we got to move out and make it real and make it a part of our way of life. So.